I was so prepared.
Oh, thanks.
You can position it.
It's the tall one, I don't think I can do it.
Yeah.
Did you turn it on and this is?
He must have turned it on.
I don't know.
See, that's in come. And I read this. Do I stay up and read this too? She's the first reader. Do I just get up there?
You could. I mean,
people like.
Check with a little, I think it's a royal reading. Father Jim will be his supervisor.
Oh, that's nice. That's great. You and I are going to pick up. We didn't have coffee hour next week. I'm going to pick up Pete's coffee.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of making the coffee upstairs, having somebody bring it down the stairs, just buy Pete's coffee. It's $25 a week.
Yeah, and so, you stay warm in that thing.
Yeah. Yeah, and we go right by it. You go right by it. Well, I don't know. Do you take the highway?
I don't go by because I take the highway and then get off and come almost directly.
Yeah, so you don't go to the either one of Starbucks or Pete's, but still.
There's a Starbucks by the house.
Oh, I see.
There's one right here.
All right, well, I'll put you down for the second week. Oh, this one's yours, John. All right. That's great.
Oh, I gotta make sure that's the week I'm here. You're talking about May 14th?
Sounds good.
I won't be here, just so you know. I'll be in Colombia.
Oh, third week?
No, second week.
No, third week?
Oh, no, I'll be back by the third week. I'll be jet lagged.
Okay, so I'll put it down for the third.
Thank you.
Actually, speaking into the microphone, the microphones are perfect, actually.
Yeah, but we can't.
Gino lives here and Dwayne lives in New York. And so Burb is welcomed, has welcomed the opportunity that if any of y'all want to come and share memories and come say hi to him, and we'll love that. So consider making some time here to do so.
We'll also put Burb's address in the newsletter so that you can write cards and notes to him if you're unable to make it. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Son Jesus is the good shepherd of your people. Grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever.
Amen. The first lesson is from Acts. Those who have been baptized devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and the prayers. Came upon everyone, because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions, goods, distribute the proceeds to all as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God, having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you are able and chant the song with me in this tune.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down.
A reading from Peter. It is credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you do right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed, for you were going astray like sheep, but now you have returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A common question in Bible study and theological reflection is, where do you see yourself in this story? In the case of Jesus' metaphor about himself as the good shepherd, I can only give one possible answer. I'm certainly not the shepherd. I hope I'm not a thief, a bandit, or a so that leaves the sheep. Besides, Jesus is clearly referring to his followers as sheep. The trouble with this, most people I know don't much like being compared to sheep. Even a couple of the commentaries that I read on this passage acknowledge that people think of sheep as unintelligent or dim-witted, with no question as to the accuracy of this perception. However, in 2009, when we went hiking in Scotland, where there are more sheep than 1 square mile than there are in all of Albany County, our guide told us that the cattle farms, the grates and the pavement that keep the cattle from the mountains, don't work for sheep. The sheep learn how to lie down and roll over the cattle. I wasn't sure whether this was true, but if anyone believes it, they clearly have more respect for sheep than most Americans I know. So I got to wondering, are sheep really stupid, or are they just misunderstood? I read about sheep and shepherds. I talked with people about sheep. Finally, I asked Google, are sheep stupid? I concluded that sheep are misunderstood. Sheep are herd animals, after all, and so they don't demonstrate a lot of individual initiative and independence, the qualities that modern culture, especially in America, hold in high esteem. They are also quite vulnerable to predators and need protection, not the kind of brave, strong animals we like to identify with. Never mind that most of us wouldn't stand much of a chance against an angry wolf. But sheep are not stupid. The internet corroborated the cattle guard story. It seems that there was a BBC News report in 2004 of sheep rolling over a cattle guard in order to sample their genetics. An eyewitness said, "It is quite clever, but they are a big nuisance to the villagers." There were also studies done in Australia and at Cambridge University in which sheep demonstrated superior memory, facial recognition, and problem-solving skills. The researchers concluded that sheep are very intelligent animals. So why am I going to all this trouble to convince you that sheep aren't stupid? Because I think that if we stop being insulted when we're compared to sheep, we can learn something. I doubt that Jesus' disciples were insulted that he called them sheep. We've heard that first century Jewish culture was much community than on individuals. And a middle-class modern American, I'm not even sure I can imagine such a radically different orientation. We're talking early childhood to compete with each other, to try to stand out from the crowd. The word dependency is tinged with a connotation of weakness. Sheep recognize the importance of community. They form friendships with each other, emotional bonds. Sheep understand that they need protection from the predators of this world. Sheep recognize and follow people who protect and guide them. There are at least a couple of modern stories of attempted thefts of sheep. The would-be thieves tried to drive flocks away from their pens, but when they heard the unique call of their shepherds, the sheep turned around and ran back. What does it mean to be the body of Christ? Each of us is an individual member of that body, but the image reminds us that we are part of something larger, something in which each member has a unique part to play that is not separate. Now and then, to imagine ourselves as a flock of very intelligent sheep. We need each other for companionship and support. We trust the Good Shepherd to lead us. We need to recognize his voice above all others. Please stand as you are able. And you must confess our words and the apostles' creed. I believe in God, the Father of all humanity,
creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
As Christ has taught us, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need.
The shepherd who gathers us in your mighty and loving arms. Help your church to listen for your voice, especially when the voices of sin, idolatry, and oppression threaten to overpower us. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
The green pastures, still waters, and dark valleys of this earth all belong to you, O God. Sustain your creation with a love that is both mighty and just. Where there is destruction, bring healing. Where there is desolation, bring abundance. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You are the sheep gate that gives safety to your beloved flocks. Provide protection for refugees, victims of domestic violence, those who are in prison, and for all people who are vulnerable to violence and mistreatment. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
You journey with us wherever our paths may lead. We pray for those feeling overwhelmed by anxiety or depression or suffering in any way. Please offer your own petitions.
I'd like to pray for Malia and Adelina, and also for little baby Ardana.
You call your sheep by name and lead them through the valley of death. We give you thanks for those who have died and now dwell in your house forever. Be with those who mourn and give them hope in the promise of resurrection. Please name those you wish to remember.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, one more,
to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of us. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this knowledge, knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen. O God, our shepherd, you know your sheep by name and lead us to safety through the valleys of death. Guide us by your voice, that maybe we may walk in certainty and security to the joyous feast prepared in your house. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Are there any announcements first?
Sure, I'll announce our next concert. We are having a concert of French organ music here in the sanctuary on May 21st with Joy Leilani Garbutt, who has a PhD in musicology and specializes in French organ music by female composers. She came and rehearsed on our Hooks and Beatings organ yesterday, and it will be a light. Hope to see you all.
Anyone else? Yes, Sam.
Just want to remind everybody that next Sunday is our first Sunday, so we will be having communion service.
This afternoon at 4 p.m., the Berkeley Women's Community Chorus is having a concert at the North Bridge Church. And that's always a lot of fun, the Women's Chorus concert. And they're free. Thank you.
Anyone else? All right. Any announcements regarding birthdays, travelers, anniversaries, events, celebrations? Come on up. Mine's birthday is tomorrow.
My daughter Lisa's track from the East Coast today, after her educational meeting, and I want to tell you she received the high certificate for clinical excellence.
All right, this is
Lisa.
Lisa.
Yeah.
So draw my hand.
Wonderful.
All right. And it's in the bulletin, so you don't even have to scramble for it. Oh God,
our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servant Holly, as she begins to appear. Grant that she may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen her trust in your goodness all the days of her life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
And for Lisa, traveling and
wonderful,
great at what she's in, and does. And she's Larry's daughter, lucky girl. Oh God, our heavenly Father,
whose glory fills all creation, and whose presence we find wherever we go, consider those
on the next page.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
That's why I said you can go by and say hi. Is that a guess?
Turn it off.